G'day everyone, welcome to the Opal Mills. Today, got a couple of boxes, well, parcels, to open. And I'm pretty sure they're going to be Opal related, so might as well do it on camera. So, from what I'm gathering with this one, there's going to be a couple of stones. Oh, sorry guys. A couple of stones. With a couple of rings in mind. Now these are rough and we'll need cutting from my understanding. Oops, not a bag. Well, got a few stones here. I'm not getting on a plane with these. They're not wrapped properly. So, what have we got here? Wow, that's a big colour. Looks like the face is up that way. In the face too well there. This is gonna be fun. I might just quickly unwrap all these and come back. So, one stone. Just a couple of stones. Ooh, some really nice color in this. Oh, wow. Check that out. That's gorgeous. Ooh. I gather this one's to be cut into an oval. Wow. Potch bar separating that, I can see. Double sided. Pretty back. We'll get an oval out of it. I'm sure. Okay. Slot that in there so I don't get mixed up. This is just full of colour. The shell, nice. Maybe a ring stone. Oh, I don't think there'll be a problem with making that into a ring stone. Looks like it could have been part of either a shell or a bell or not. Third layer, beautiful. A few options. Safekeeping. Maybe a kite pendant. Very pretty. Wow, some really nice color there. Another maybe a ring stone. Ooh, another belemnite. This one definitely. Oh wow. That, you're looking at slicing in half as two ring stones. Wow. A pair of earrings. A pair of earrings would look fantastic out of this. That is gorgeous material. Wow. And yes, this colour is pretty much just as good in person. A Mosaic Wise Oval. Very nice. Little stone in there. It's a bit darker jelly crystal. There's a little bit of a shell by the curve. Could be. But, wow. Unfortunately, all the reds are intermixed up into this brown surface. By the time you clear it off, it'll go. Yeah, there's a nice red bar just up the top there. Yeah, well, this is going to be fun. Okay, that leaves one more box. So, we'll find out which way this box opens. From what I understand, we should be looking at some matrix. So, immediately, that's broken. So, just lose some touch, but there's two pieces in there. And there's another piece. So, hoping that was sent like that. But I've got a sneaky suspicion it wasn't. And holy wow, the colour I can see in here automatically. Let's just zoom in. Well, actually, let's just show it as is. So this is quite a large piece. Very, very large. Ooh, hint, 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 hint. And wow. Sit up there for a sec. Get to go about this piece, which is, it dwarfs the other piece. So, wow. I'll have to zoom right out. Just to give you an idea. Now, I'm gonna grab some water from over here. And I'm just gonna have a quick look at this. So, you could be seeing what I'm seeing. Yes, the camera is picking it up. And that's just what you can see on the outset. And what I noticed when I looked in here, when this came out. Oh, wow. That is gorgeous. And it goes all the way through. Now, this does look to be very glassy. So if I wipe some water on there, it doesn't seem to want to just soak in like over here it does. It's dried up very well, that'll treat nicely. But some of this is a bit glassy. It's a bit concerning. as the treatment needs to be able to penetrate the stone or it won't take a treatment. Wow. So let's take this piece and we're going to go stick it into the pot. And we're going to go turn that on and cook that with the rest of everything else in that pot. That is red all the way through the top there. I'm not just, yeah, wow. Amazing. So fingers crossed, let's go put this in the pot. And this will probably come out in a future video, the results. All right, so before we go and attack a couple of those stones we had just before, so a quick look at this with some water on it. So there's a huge pendant stone to be had there. No, I'm joking. I'm really hoping this is gonna treat. I've got a sneaky suspicion some of it's gonna be untreatable, but these have still cut some fantastic stones as is. It's almost crystally on top there, so that might actually get a really nice couple of stones off the top there if there's a good spot. Just little spots of crystal. If that somehow joins up into a big enough piece to get a good face, might get some solid. See the veins going in and around the matrix of more concentrated opal. This is very black looking too for a untreated matrix. To the camera, it's pretty heavy. Now with the treatment, if it all goes to plan, a lot of this blotchiness goes unnoticed with all the black from the carbonization. This is gonna be fun. So, I'm gonna put these aside for a bit and pick out a couple of stones to cut. It's just putting them away. I thought I'd tidy all this off. Some chips, but check that out. Might even get a little stone off that bit. Might chuck him in for the cut. Little bit awkward cut, but might get a stone out of this end. Okay, so pulled out a couple. This is the first one that we were looking at. A nice bit of flash through the side. So we'll give that one a go by the look of it. I'm drawing a little shape on there, trying to salvage clearly as much as possible, and that's what we'll do.
bit concerned about this sand and if it goes in and how far, because that'll break up, and I think it's going to be honest. Actually, that's a very big concern. Seems to be clear all the way there, so hopefully if we just gently rub it, these wounds are superficial on the side and this, and don't actually go all the way through. We'll have to find out. It'd be such a shame if you can't cut a stone from that. And the second one we're going to get to is a serving suggestion of maybe a kite shape. Well, this one, I think kite shape we can do. So we're going to head over to the wheel and give these a little bit of a rub back and see if there's anything we need to adjust for. I want to start with this one because it's given me the most cause for concern and see what happens. Best case scenario, these disappear straight away and don't cause any fracturing at all through the stone. They seem to be clearing up. Just a little bit there. Get away with it, I think. Maybe. Any further work, that's just going to snap through those points. We know we could cut it up that way. We need it to face this way. This one's here.
give it a go. Thinner this side than this side. Hopefully it doesn't get too thinned out. Trying to flatten the back of it. Skin on the top. That's going to be fantastic when it's done. So I'll just tidy this one up while I'm here. See what we can get out of it. start with this one. Try and get all these marks out.
Thank you.
Okay, so here's our little chip that came out of the matrix parcel. It's a nice little oval. Let's see if that treats. Be nice if it went really dark. Get that colour to pop. And we're over here, we have the kite one. Now, while it survived the cut, clearly it's going to have a couple of issues. One being this split right here. Another one of something there. So it's got a couple of bits and pieces like that in it. But be a very nice specimen for the collection. Nothing else. And then this one. This one's got a gorgeous little flash in it. Get ready for it. Rolling. Now here's the kicker. Check this out. Let's see if I can get it to do it. That's a full flood on the back, but this had the bits of sand and stuff. Just a little spot left in it there. It's getting very thin. But yeah, nice rolling flush on this side. So that'll be an open back little pennant stone. Very beautiful, very bright. So yeah, there we go. Get on with a few more of these and see you next video. Hopefully we'll have the matrix treated up very soon. I'll go put this in a pot with it, and probably in a few days that video will come out sometime later this week. Anyway, cheers.